Then Robert Guerrero, Keith Thurman, to be that excited. Dude's just going at it, man. It's top notch.
What impressed you the most about Keith Thurman in there today?
I mean, he's versatile, man. I thought he was just going to come forward, try to knock out Robert Guerrero, which was going to be tough. And he showed his versatility, man. He came out, you know, started boxing a little bit after the exchanges. But then he gave fans a good fight. Not only that, but fights like that save the game of boxing.
It was important for them to put on that kind of show, because the first fight, a lot of people weren't too happy with them, Lena Broder, but the second fight kind of made up for everything.
You gotta understand, man. You know what I'm saying? We all want to see blood, guts, and all that, knockouts. But you gotta understand, these fighters out here fighting to win. And however they will get the win is how they get the win. So you really can't knock them for that. So Broner got his decision, victory over John Molina, which is a tough guy. You can never count him out. And, I mean, he did what he had to do.
What's up with the Instagram battle? You and Jesse Hart is going to be on the Mayweather-Pacquiao card.
Nothing is signed or anything like that. You know, I feel like I'm going backwards fighting an eight-round fighter. You know what I'm saying? Nothing to take away from the kid. He's supposed to call people out. He's supposed to call people out that he feel that he can beat. You know what I'm saying? But me, if you feel you can beat me, earn your way to the spot, get your rounds up, and we can make it happen. Definitely. I'm definitely not going to take a pay cut like none of you would. Right. You know what I'm saying? So that's kind of going backwards. You know?
Have you ever met him? Do you ever hang out with him? Do you know him?
Never. I've known Jesse from in the amateurs. He's a very good amateur, very decorated amateur. Won a lot of tournaments and things like that. You know what I mean? Never no bad blood, and it's no bad blood. Nah, this is the sport of boxing. You got to do what you got to do. You know, he's representing Philadelphia well. You know what I mean? He's one of the rising stars in the game. So, you know what I mean? He's doing exactly what he's supposed to do. You know, if he calls me out, you know, I got to bite back like he would. You know?
What does it mean to jleon to fight on the biggest fight of our lifetime, Mayweather Pacquiao, to be on that card?
Man, it's unbelievable.
Why?
It's unbelievable because, I mean, you know, I was a young boy, you know, wasn't even around. You got the Tyson Holyfields and, you know, you got the Muhammad Ali, George Foreman, and now you have Mayweather Pacquiao. You know what I'm saying? This is crazy. The elite stuff, man. So that makes me step my game 1,000%. You know what I mean? And that's what I needed. I needed to go out and revamp and go back to the old jleon that I need to be. The one that had people hype about me, not the one that's having close decisions or whatever the case. So, you know, I just needed to step my game up, and that's what I'm doing now.
Does that mean you don't need to buy a ticket?
I'm definitely not buying a ticket. No, not at all. I don't care how much money I make. $6,000, I'll go spend that on something else, not a ticket.
How did you feel promoted? He kind of singled you out. I mean, he gives you a lot of attention, a lot of advice, kind of took you under his wing a bit. I mean, how does that make you feel as a fighter and a person?
I mean, it's a blessing, man. You know, that's one of my best friends. You know what I'm saying? Me and Floyd, you know, I mean, you know, like I said, man, you know, I met a lot of people on this road to being, to wanting to be a champion. And you know, that's one person I met, man, that, you know, just a genuine person, a genuine individual. And I got his back 100%, he got mine. So, you know, that's what it is.
When you first came to the gym, did you ever envision you would be like this, be his friend, be in the position you're in now?
Nah, you know, I just coming to, you know, make the stage for myself, and then eventually stand on the stage and do what I got to do. And you know, God put you in a different position, man. And you know, this is the position He put me in.
Were you a fan of Floyd growing up? I mean, recent years, not as a kid.
Yeah,
why?
Of course.
What was it about him?
First off, from Michigan. Grand Rapids, I'm from Detroit, you know, or Inkster, Michigan, but you know, the bigger city, Detroit. I used to like Zab, I mean, still do. Those are the two guys that I like. You know, Zab used to have the grill in his mouth. I used to think that was fly. The dude had the grill in his mouth, he was fly.
Did you ever get one?
Nah.
Why not? You can do it now.
I got nice teeth, man. I ain't doing that like that. You know what I'm saying?
So, and what was it about Floyd?
And just how he was, man.
The
you
money,
know, he can fight. You know, I come from, this is every place, but where I'm from is, you know, I've always seen the flash. My dad was a street guy, and my brother was a street guy. You know what I'm saying? I was in the streets, so flashy was it. Big wads of money, the jewelry, you know what I mean? The nice cars, the furs, whatever the cake, the gators. You know, only a few people know about the gators, you know what I'm saying? So the gators, stuff like that, man, that was it. You know what I mean? So that's something I've always, you know, attracted myself to. That's what I wanted. You know what I'm saying? But now I know that it goes beyond that. You know what I'm saying? You know, so You know, that's why I liked him. And then the dude can fight. You know, he talked shit and he backed it up.
I think people don't give him no credit, man. I mean, I remember once he said, you know, people don't forget I'm a fighter. Like, I can fight. Did you forget that?
Man, you know what, man? It really don't matter what people think. I mean, you know, people are spending crazy amount of money to come see this man fight. Whether win or lose, they're gonna pay. So
you get to see him in the gym fight every day almost.
Yeah, you know what I'm saying? But at the end of the day, it really don't matter what anybody says, right? I mean, they're gonna tune in May 2nd, regardless of what they think about him, to see him fight win or lose, whatever.
How do you see that fight playing out against Pacquiao?
You know, I think Floyd gonna fuck around and stop the shit out of him, bro. Like, nasty. I'm not saying that's my dude, you know, my homie, you know what I'm saying? But real shit, like, I just watched him spar. All right, yo, we got to think. We were 6 months off. We was all around, you know, flying and everything. You know what I'm saying? So,
it's just one first week.
Is there a different hunger for this fight?
I see it. I think so. I definitely see it. I mean, yo, you, I don't know. You know, you guys been to camps to interview Floyd. Everybody be there at 3 o'clock. Floyd will show up at 6. Floyd is there at 3 o'clock. No doubt. You know what I'm saying? He just on time with everything he's on. Yeah, I can just see it in his face. And I think he's just going to demolish his career.
Are you absorbing this, that you're part of this camp and part of this fight, or are you going to wait till years from now to soak it all in?
No, I can't wait till years from now. You know, tomorrow's never promised, so I got to soak it in now. You know what I mean?
And what's it like for you to be in a private jet growing? Like, you grew up very rough, yeah. And now you're living the life of very few.
It's a blessing. That's all I can say. You know what I mean? It's a blessing. And I'm happy to be in the position I'm in.
Message to your fans if they're watching?
Thank you. I love you. The ones that hate me, the ones that don't, I love you all. You know what I'm saying? I wish I could hug you all and duck the slaps that you were trying to give me, but whatever. You know, no, it's all love, man. You know, I appreciate the support that you give me. You know, hope nothing but for me to put on good fights, you know what I mean? And do better than what I've done so far.
Thank you, man. Good luck.
There you have it. jleon love. FaceReport.com and Ballistic Bike reporting. Thanks.